Very good morning to all the dignitaries, fellow colleagues, and all dear friends. I welcome you all to the celebration of National Doctors' Day, that is 1st July 2020. I welcome our chief guest, Padma Shri Professor Dr. Jagat Ram, who has taken out time from his busy schedule to be with us today. Thank you, sir. I'm Dr. Aastha Sharma, oral and maxillofacial surgeon and general secretary and technical advisor, Cypher. I'll be hosting this session today. I'll be telling a brief about Cypher. Cypher stands for Strategic Institute for Public Health Education and Research. It was established in 2018 with the primary purpose of creating a specialized public health workforce who can plan, execute, and monitor national health programs and public health initiatives for tackling emerging public health challenges. Cypher has already held about 15 consultations and other activities with School of Public Health, PGI, and many other organizations. Now coming to history of Doctors Day, why we celebrate this day. National Doctors Day is celebrated on 1st July all across India. It is done to honor the legendary physician, second Chief Minister of West Bengal, Dr. B.C. Roy. Dr. Roy was honored with the country's highest civilian award, that being the Bharat Ratna, on February 4, 1961. The celebration of Doctors Day is an attempt to emphasize on the value of doctors in our lives and to offer them our respect by commemorating one of their greatest representatives. National Doctors Day theme for this year is to lessen the mortality of COVID-19. As we all know that we are deeply concerned about COVID-19's impact on individuals, especially those having comorbid conditions such as hypertension, cardiovascular diseases, diabetes, etc. Now, I would like all of us to observe silence for a minute so that we can observe this for the doctors and other corona warriors in respect for them. Over 300 doctors and many other corona warriors have lost their lives since the pandemic was first reported in the country. So let's observe a silence of 1 minute.
Yeah, thank you, Asa.
Thank you. Thank you, all of you. Now I would like to invite Dr. Rakesh Gupta, who's the President and Director of Public Health Cypher. Formerly, he was DHS and Director of Chemical Examiner Lab Punjab, alumni of John Hopkins School of Public Health, Baltimore 2012, and University of California, San Francisco 2012, as a short-term scholar. Dr. Rakesh Gupta.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Asta. So I welcome Padma Shri Dr. Jagat Ram, Director PGI-MER, and Professor and Head Advanced Eye Center PGI-MER Chandigarh. I also welcome all our guests of honor and eminent experts of national and international repute who have bestowed us the honor by joining us. So we'll be playing a short video messages from Honorary Chief Secretary Punjab and Dr. Shrinath Reddy, President PHFI. They could not join us because of their prior commitments. Madam Vinnie Mahajan, she is a 1987 batch IS officer. She is Chief Secretary Chief Secretary Punjab, and she is the first women bureaucrat to be elevated to the top post. She has held many important posts, including ACS Health, Investment and Promotion, Industries and Commerce, IT and Governance Reforms, and Public Grievances. As Principal Secretary Health and Family Welfare and ACS Health, she initiated many public health activities for which she has been acclaimed internationally. She is an economic graduate from Lady Shri Ram College, Delhi University, and an MBA from IIM Calcutta. She was awarded the Hubert Humphrey Fellowship by the United States Department of State, Satyan Mehta Memorial National Literacy Award, National Prize for Outstanding Achievement in Popularizing Mahila Samriddhi Yojana. Please listen to her message for the occasion.
Doctors have been considered a form of godliness because they give life and save life and preserve life and give quality to life. And in doing so, they don't care about their own personal inconveniences or even sometimes danger to their own lives. For example, in this pandemic of COVID, when doctors have been at the forefront of the battle, regardless of possible infection and harm to themselves. We salute these brave people, these blessings to society, those who at grave personal cost and risk are tending to the infirm, to the ill, and saving them for their families and for society. My greetings to all doctors, my best wishes. We are proud of PGI Chandigarh, and Director Dr. Jagatram is being honored on this day. My very special congratulations to him and also to the entire team in PGI and all doctors everywhere in the state of Punjab, the country, the world. Thank you.
We are thankful to Madam Vini Mahajan for joining us through this video message. So now I'll introduce Professor K. Srinath Reddy. He's a Padma Bhushan, President PHFI, DM Cardiology, MSc Epidemiology. He is a former HOD, Department of Cardiology, AIIMS, New Delhi. He has served on WHO expert panels, President of the World Heart Federation. He has more than 500 scientific publications in international and Indian peer-reviewed journals. He has been awarded WHO Director General Award for Outstanding Global Leadership in Tobacco Control, Luther Terry Medal for Leadership in Tobacco Control, Adjunct Professor of Epidemiology at Harvard. He is first Indian as Foreign Associate Member of the National Academy of the Medicine of the National Academy of Sciences, U.S. He is recipient of honorary doctorates from the universities of London, from Glasgow, Switzerland, and from an Indian university in Jodhpur, India. And so let us listen to his message for the occasion.
Namaste. Greetings on Doctors' Day. It is a pleasure for me to be participating in this special event being organized by the Strategic Institute for Public Health Education and Research, SIFER. The theme of Doctors' Day this year is particularly important because it calls on all doctors to try and reduce the deaths due to COVID-19. Even as many parts of the country are now waging a battle against the virus, it is somewhat heartening for us to know that the death rates due to COVID in terms of deaths per million are relatively low in India. However, since the virus has not touched many individuals in this country, particularly in smaller towns and cities and in rural areas, we have to now take many measures to protect the virus from spreading. At the same time, we have to try and save the lives of those who have been infected by the virus. It is important that the doctors who are playing such a selfless role in providing services to the people who need, irrespective of any concern for their own personal safety, should be saluted and thanked on this particular day. However, as doctors, we also have an additional duty. We have to ensure that we build a very strong health system, which is functioning well in the steady state, so that it can actually build surge capacity very well during a public health emergency. Unfortunately, we have not invested adequately in building that kind of health system across the country. What we need to do is to invest more of our public financing and ensure that we have universal health coverage, which can be delivered through an efficient and empathetic healthcare delivery system. Otherwise, doctors themselves, however noble and hardworking they are, will be functioning against the inefficiencies of a weak health system. So while we must now do our very best and save lives, we must also try and advocate for universal health coverage based on an efficient and empathetic healthcare system. We also recognize that many of the deaths in this particular epidemic of COVID-19 are occurring in people with comorbidities, people who have coronary heart disease, respiratory disease, or cardiovascular disease and hypertension together, or even who are on cancer chemotherapy. Many of them have been smokers and tobacco consumers. So we have to also advocate for programs which will actually reduce non-communicable diseases and other comorbidities and bring strict controls on noxious agents like tobacco, which increase the risk of disease as well as the risk of death from COVID. So we have a role both as caregivers as well as advocates for health promoting policies. And on Doctors' Day, we must recognize that we have this role to guide patients, not only to better health, but also to guide the society in India to a healthier status. I wish you all the best and thank you very much again.
Now I'd like to introduce Dr. Jagatram. He is Padmashri Professor Dr. Jagatram. He is an eminent ophthalmologist, is head Advanced Eye Center and Director of Postgraduate Institute of Medical Education and Research. He has received the Oscar of Pediatric Ophthalmology at the World Congress of Pediatric Ophthalmology and Strabismus in Barcelona. He assumed the office of director at PGI in March 2017. He was conferred Padma Shri Award by the President of India in January 2019. And in 2020, he has completed 41 years of service in PGI MER. The Board of Directors of CIFR, they have resolved to honor an eminent personality on National Doctors' Day every year. And Dr. Jagatram has been chosen to be honored this year for his selfless service to the society. So we'll request all our guests to collectively release the annual report of the CIFR. Yes, next. Yeah. Next. 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 So you may all say release. Release. Yeah.
Release.
Release.
Release. Release.
Release. Release.
Release.
Thank you. We have now virtually released this annual report. Sharing this online.
Please.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Ma'am Harjinder. So we'll share this by email to all of you. Next, Asta. So Dr. Jagatram, he went to his office and he released it formally also. And this is the award given to Dr. Jagatram. So we'll request Dr. Jagatram now to address us.
Dr. K.H. Reddy, President Public Health Foundation of India and Padma Bhushan Awardee, Government of India. Dr. Rakesh Gupta, President and Director of the Public Health Strategic Institute. Dr. Astha Sharma, General Secretary and Technical Advisor, CIFR. Dr. Arun Verma, Director of Finance and Operations, CIFR. Professor Sonu Goyal, Department of Community Medicine, PGI, and my dear colleagues. On this occasion of 1st July, Doctors Day, I would like to extend my heartfelt greeting to all my respected teacher, senior, fellow colleagues, student, resident doctors and fellows. Doctors' Day celebration in India offers us a great opportunity for spreading awareness about the roles, importance, responsibilities of the doctor, as well as promote medical professional to come closer and follow the responsibility of their profession very dedicatedly. As we know, this day is celebrated in the memory of Dr. Vidhan Chandra Ray in order to pay honor to the entire medical profession. Doctors' Day in India was established by Government of India in 1991. 5 July is the death anniversary of most famous physician of India, Dr. B.C. Roy. Dr. Roy was Bharat Ratna, as already said. He was born on 1st July 1882 in Patna, Bihar. He had completed his medical graduation from Calcutta and returned to India in 1911 after completing his MRCP and FRCS degree in London, and began his medical career as physician in India in the same year. He was a famous physician and renowned educationist as well as freedom fighter, as he joined Mahatma Gandhi during civil disobedience movement. Large population of India depends in many ways on physicians and their quality treatment, which shows the remarkable improvement and progress in the care and treatment methods. The celebration of this day is a noble attempt to put emphasis on the role played by doctors in our lives. When any individual of the society has failing health or a health emergency, the doctor respond at any moment of time, and they act as a true savior for the patient. Without paying heed to their own interest, doctors have been entrusted with the most noble task of treating all patients under the Hippocratic oath without paying much attention to the patient's caste, creed, race, or financial status. What can we do as doctors? The doctor-patient relationship is sacred and based on mutual trust and respect. This relationship must be strengthened as it forms the backbone of the medical care. Other than treating patients, doctors should also play a positive leadership role in the community. In addition, doctor must have 6 A's, that is the availability. A doctor must always be available to all the patients during the working hours to deliver care with empathy and compassion. Accessibility, a patient should be able to freely express his or her concern to doctors. Affability, a doctor must greet his patient affectionately all the times and empathize with the patient's concern. Ability, a doctor should have competence to treat the patient. Affordability, a patient should be provided cost-effective medical care of highest standard. Accountability, of course, every doctor is accountable for his or her action. In the current era, we are facing an unprecedented challenge on humanity. The ongoing COVID pandemic crisis is the single largest threat to the humanity world over. And it is not only only threaten to destroy the human lives, but also the institution, finances, market, and infrastructure. A small invisible virus has waged a war on humanity, and in this war, it is the doctors and the healthcare worker who are at the forefront of a long battle. Unfortunately, several of our colleagues have themselves come to the illness. As already said, more than 300 healthcare workers, they have lost their life. However, I am proud today that our medical fraternity has not bowed down and is playing a great leadership role in restoring normalcy globally. In India, doctors face another challenge, that is the suboptimal infrastructure and burdening number of patients. But this has not shaken our indomitable spirit, and we are fighting hard to keep mankind alive. Friends, Doctors' Day is a day for recollection and reconnaissance, where we should renew our oath to serve humanity. It is a day for us to celebrate our achievements and encourage our young colleagues to take a big stride in the advancement of medicine. My heartfelt thanks for bestowing me this honor on this very auspicious occasion. Thank you very much, and wish you all a very happy Doctor's Day. Thank you very much.
So, thank you, Dr. Jagatram, for joining us. We know you are busy. You are fighting the COVID battle and from the front as a great leader. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you very much.
Now I'd like to introduce Mr. Arun Verma, Director Operations and Finance Cypher. He's an electrical engineer by profession, having master's degree in power systems. He is Fellow of Institution of Engineers and Fellow of Indian Council of Arbitration. He has an experience of 41 years on different important assignments, including the field of new and renewable energy, having worked as Director Punjab Energy Development, Director Distribution Punjab State Power Corporation, Director UHBVN, Director HVPN, Director HPGCL, and Managing Director of Dakshin Haryana Power Corporation. He was invited by the World Bank to share his experience in sizable reduction of carbon footprint through introduction of high voltage distribution system in agriculture sector in state of Punjab.
Thank you, Dr. Astha. A very good morning to all the dignitaries and eminent participants, as well as the entire medical fraternity of our country. I'll briefly share about the mission, vision, aims, and objectives of Cypher. Our mission is to contribute to health and well-being of all the people through strengthening public health education, supporting, developing, and implementing evidence-based public health, and scaling up locally relevant research in India and beyond for overall achievement of health-related goals and targets. Vision and values: supporting public health actions for accelerating progress towards achieving healthy lives and promoting well-being of all. Cypher has been founded with certain core values which form the base for carrying out its activities and program. Health equity and social justice: highest possible standards of interdisciplinary services, innovation-driven and evidence-based operational solutions, creating leaders who have a passion and commitment and respect for the community, enhancing solidarity and accountability to overcome public health challenges. Next. We have certain aims and objectives. To organize or participate in an academic or research-related seminar workshop, collaborate with institutions of repute or experts, receive donations and grants for furtherance of its objectives. support and collaborate with the national and subnational governments to identify gaps in program implementation for overall health system strength. Next. Before coming to the activities it has undertaken, I wish to add that at the time of creation of CIPHER, mission, vision, and aims and objectives never set as conceived or perceived with limited knowledge about the likely flow of response of subject-related experts and the participants as we move forward. Experiencing an overwhelming response of fraternity of public health experts, wholehearted support of the eminent experts, and wholehearted support of the Department of Community Medicine and School of Public Health, PGMIR, and the enthusiasm of the state and the center government to consider the recommendations on after consultation with the experts, CIPHER 2 has actively initiated the process of expanding the scope of mission, vision, and objectives. Now CIPHER wishes to aim and achieve a target healthy Punjab and of course a healthy India, for which we seek the support and all the eminent experts of public. Now coming to the activities of the CIPHER during 2018-19, I would like to share that in a very small period of about 1 year, we have held about 9 consultation workshops or activities. I wish to mention here that all the consultation workshop activities were held either in collaboration or in coordination with the Department of Community Medicine and School of Public Health, PGMIR, under the overall leadership of Dr. Amarjit Singh, professor and head, as well as Dr. Sonu Guru. The activities were undertaken on the 2nd of February 2019 is a consultation on health effects of the electronic nicotine delivery system, e-cigarettes, with the subject experts, decision makers, and the implementers. This consultation was, chief guest was about Mr. K.S. Pannu, the commissioner, FDA, as well as the Secretary of Agriculture. He was the chief guest. Dr. L. Swastikan, CMO, Ministry of Health and Family Affairs, Assistant Commissioner, Drug Administration, and DIG, State Cyber Cell, also participated. The outcome of these recommendations were sent to the Government of Punjab as well as the Government of India. You all know that during December 2019, the Government of India has passed an act, prohibition of the electronic cigarette, where it is a production, manufacture, import, export, transport, sale, storage, and achievement, and advertising, all banned. This activity number 2, which was held on 16th of March 2019, consultation on protecting minors from the tobacco nicotine going beyond cigarettes and other tobacco products Act 2003. This activity was, you know, participated by Chairperson and Commission for Protection of Child Rights, CPCR, Chandigarh, as well as Haryana. Shri K.S. Pannu, IS Commissioner, FDA Punjab, Shri K.K. Yadav, IS Commissioner, Municipal Corporation, Chandigarh, Dr. Nirleep Kaur, State Nodal Officer, NTCP, and Department of Health and Family Welfare, Punjab. The output and recommendations suggesting a strict implementation of all the anti-tobacco laws, especially JJ Act, to be ensured by all the stakeholders over the state governments, as well as Government of India. On 4th May 2019, consultations on reinvigorating iBanking through promotion of hospital cornea retrieval program. 29th June 2019, consultation on tobacco 21. Why legal age to buy tobacco and the legal nicotine product should be increased from 18 to 21 years. The consultation was chaired by Sardar Balbir Singh, Health Minister Punjab, and participated by Dr. Rana J. Singh, Deputy Regional Director of the Union, Dr. Nalep Kaur, SNO, NTCP, Department of Health and Family Welfare. The recommendations were sent to the Government of Punjab and Government of India. The only solution to reduce tobacco use in the youth by increasing the minimum sale age from 18 to 25 years. It is also a legal age to buy the liquor in the Punjab. From 28 to 30th September 2019, World Heart Day campaign was celebrated by CIPHER in collaboration with PGI, and a cyclothon was flagged up from the PGI premises by none other than Dr. Jagatram, Padmashri Dr. Jagatram. And the program was for 3 days. We have organized it in the different parts of the. On 30th November, state level inception workshop on the hypertension prevention and management was held. The chief guest was again Sardar Balbir Singh, Health Minister of Punjab, and was participated by Dr. Om Prakash Behra, Country Coordinator, India Global Health Advocacy, Dr. Bhavna Sharma, Country Director, RTSL India, Dr. G.V. Singh, State Program Officer, NPC-DCS, Punjab, Dr. Anit Kaur, State Program Officer, Health and Wellness Center, Dr. Ashish Bhatia, Professor, Department of Internal Medicine, PGI, Dr. S.S. Sodhi, Senior Cardiologist, President, IMA, Dr. Akshay Anand, Professor, Department of Neurology, PGI, and Dr. Nancy Sane, Veterinarian, APC. On 15th of February, a seminar on hypertension and prevention was, and prevention and management was, on 15th February, seminar on hypertension prevention and management was held. And on 13th March, state level workshop for media persons entitled Combating Hypertension, a Salient Epidemic, the Role of the Media. This was with a sole purpose to spread awareness of regarding the hypertension, orient the media towards the rise of non-communicable diseases and to encourage adoption of health lifestyles, make them aware about the risk factors of NCD and appropriate measures and to curb the progression. Engage media person in educating health promotion activity, dissemination of relevant information and accurate information. The last, during the financial year of 1920, was on 17 March, seminar on practical connection of the importance of human relationship as managing substance abuse. These were the activities, and apart from these activities, during 20, we have had so many webinars for which, the virtual conferences, workshop, and consultations. Dr. Rakesh Gupta will share with you the details on that. Thank you so much.
Dr. Rakesh Gupta? Dr. Rakesh Gupta, we'd like you to present the annual report presentations, glimpses of major activities in 2018-2019 and 2019-2020.
So thank you, Asta and Mr. Arun Verma. Yeah, next. So actually, Mr. Verma has already told you in detail about all the consultations held. So I'll just scroll through this. So this was the consultation on health effects of electronic cigarettes. Next. So consultation on protecting minors from tobacco nicotine going beyond cigarettes. And Madam Harjinder Kaur and Madam Jyoti. Madam Harjinder Kaur is chairperson CPCR Chandigarh. And Madam Jyoti is chairperson CPCR Haryana. So they are with us and they also joined in the consultation. Thank you. Next. Next. So this was consultation on reinvigorating, So this was consultation on reinvigorating eye banking through promotion of hospital cornea retrieval program. So I may tell you that Madam Vini Mahajan, when she was Principal Secretary Health Family Welfare, and I was the state program officer for the National Program for Control of Blindness, we started this initiative, that cornea blindness backlog free initiative. So just to activate this, this consultation was held. And the recommendations were sent to the center government. Next. Next. Yeah. So this is the consultation on tobacco 21. So to increase the legal age to buy for tobacco. So this was World Heart Day campaign celebration. And Dr. Jagatram was the chief. Next. This was state level inception workshop on hypertension prevention and management, in which Honorable HM he joined us. Next. So this was a seminar on hypertension prevention and management, which was held in PGI Chandigarh. Next. So this was state level workshop of media personals on combating hypertension, a silent epidemic, the role of media. You can see Dr. Amarjeet and Dr. Yashpal Sharma in the picture. Next. So this was a seminar on theoretical connotations of importance of human relationships in managing substance abuse. Next. And after this, starting from 23rd April, actually, we have held seven webinars, in fact. So the first webinar was held on 23rd of April, Tobacco Nicotine Use and Coronavirus Disease, in which Helis, the union, they participated. and the Resource Center for Tobacco Control, they partnered with us. So hypertension and COVID-19, role of yoga in management, it was held on 2nd May. And Global Health Advocacy Incubator, PJMEA, Journal of Integrated Medicine Case Reports. So they were all part of the program. Then we held, the third one was tobacco cessation during COVID pandemic and beyond, a need and an opportunity. It was held on 8th May. And Dr. Swasti Charan is with us. So he was part of this webinar. And on World Hypertension Day, a webinar was held in PJMEA with the help of PJMEA and GHAI. And there was a national summit on World No Tobacco Day. So it was a marathon 7 hours conference, which was held on the World No Tobacco Day with the help of PJMEA, the Union Resource Center for Tobacco Control, and NC2H. The sixth webinar was Protecting Youth from Tobacco and Nicotine Use. This was held in collaboration with Central State Library, Chandigarh. And the last one was held regarding tobacco control challenges and opportunities for dental professionals during COVID. So Dr. R.P. Gupta and Dr. R.P. Gupta, they are with us. So it was held with the in collaboration of IDA Chandigarh and ICD. Next. So our future plans are to catalyze public health activities across India, foster partnerships, capacity building courses for medical and paramedical personnel. Next. So these are our collaborators, CPCR, CCPCR, Chandigarh, then PGIMER, then IDA, IMA, SBI, IndusInd Bank, and Global Health Advocacy Incubator, OGS Hospital. They were all our collaborators in different activities. And if you are working in the field of public health, let us join hands and we welcome you at CIFO. Next.
Thank you, Dr. Rakesh. Now I'd like to welcome Dr. Sonu Goyal, who is the professor in the Department of Community Medicine and School of Public Health, PGIMER, Chandigarh. He has 18 years of rich experience in public health and health management. He has written more than 100 papers, authored 35 chapters, produced 12 films on National Health Program, and edited many public health books. He is alumnus of John Hopkins School of Public Health, Baltimore, US, and Maastricht University, the Netherlands, awarded Public Health Excellence of India by Honorable Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare in 2014, Program Director for International Public Health Management, Development sponsored by Ministry of External Affairs. Currently, he is the Vice Chair of Tobacco Control Session and also leading Empower Research Group of International Union Against TB and Lung Diseases. Dr. Sonu Goyal, we welcome you.
Thank you, Asthaji, for the detailed introduction. So first of all, good afternoon, everyone. A very happy Doctor's Day today. And at the outset, I wish to congratulate Dr. Rakesh Gupta, President and Director of Public Health of Strategic Institute of Public Health Education and Research, for choosing this important day for releasing the annual report of CIFER for financial year 2019 and 2020, along with the dignitaries present here. And we are privileged to have here Professor Jagatram, our director, PGI, who has been a driving force for all of us in the department, as well as for other departments in the institute. And we heard from Professor Srinath Reddy and Ms. Vinnie Mahajan. And we have dignitaries from all spheres here, not only from the health sector, but also from the non-health sector, who had been our collaborators in various other activities at PGI, and also they have been collaborating in various public health related activities in CIFER, as we can hear from Dr. Rakesh. And it is even more pertinent now in these challenging times of COVID pandemic, where doctors are not only playing a role of caregiver, but also lifesaver, and even risking their life along with their family life for the welfare of citizens. So now let me brief some of the activities which PGI School of Public Health, Department of Community Medicine, has done with CIFER over past 2 years. Dr. Rakesh and Mr. Arun Verma has already summarized those activities, most of the activities. But I wish to reiterate here that most of these activities were policy-focused activities, and all these activities, most of these activities led to some decisions at the state and national level government on key public health issues. And whether it is e-cigarette ban or increasing the age of selling or buying tobacco from 18 to 25, 21 or 25 years, we jointly hold like 7 to 8 webinar over last 3 to 4 months on current topic of interest, especially now, as you all know, the coronavirus, linking it with tobacco, linking it with hypertension and non-communicable diseases. And also we hold a large 7.5 hour national summit, which was attended by 600 odd participants from 14 countries, along with the 45 faculty from India and 7 countries abroad, mainly from Southeast Asia. And we also have in this forum our head of the department, Professor Amarjeet Singh, who has also, like Dr. Jagatram, who has also been forward looking for more collaborative activities with like-minded organizations like CIFAR in the interest of public health. So I wish again, Strategic Institute of Public Health Education and Research, all the best for future activities, and wish to collaborate with them in the future too, in the interest of public and overall health of the citizens. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Somu. The Governing Board of CIFAR is pleased to offer honorary membership to all our honored guests and eminent experts who have registered for this meeting. All dignitaries may now briefly introduce themselves and dwell upon the potential collaborative opportunities with CIFAR. You can tell your name, organization, and how you can partner. Can someone elaborate on this?
Dr. Rakesh, can you take the lead?
Hello.
Yeah, I'm here, Ajay Singh. Hello.
I'll just call the names. And okay. Madam Harjinder Kaur, you may please introduce yourself. Madam Harjinder, please unmute yourself.
Yeah. Thank you so much. At the outset, let me compliment CIFAR for organizing such a pious event and on such an August day, inviting us to be part of such pious event at this very moment. I must say, when on the Doctor's Day, they are not only life savers, generation saviors, and rather they have proved today that they are the gods of today. I bow before all the doctor fraternity. I salute all the doctors and really compliment the commendable work being done by all over by the doctors during these days, sacrificing their own self. Little idiom we learned in the childhood that work is worship, but what we have witnessed now is a matter of proud for the whole humanity. So I compliment and congratulate all the doctors and wish you all the very best in the coming future. And today, honoring Professor Dr. Jagatram, again, it's a wonderful, wonderful initiative. I think this is the minimum even whole humanity should be doing, that we recognize such services. And Professor Dr. Jagatram is not only the pride of the nation, rather the city beautiful is so very proud of PGI and the kind of services being provided at such epidemic which came all of a sudden, and the kind of delivery been given from your end at this very moment, it's a matter of pride for everyone. I really compliment, and we are always there anything, since we are the relating with the child rights. This is the Chandigarh Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Between the age of 0 to 18, for every child we are committed. And everybody knows that in this pandemic, the most affected will be the child health. So we'll be needing all your services in every area of health and we will welcome you and we will join hands with you for this pious cause. Dr. Rakesh, Astha and all the participants, all my compliments and deep thanks to everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Dr. Rakesh Gupta from Jaipur. Please unmute yourself.
Okay. Thank you. Congratulations to Cypher for such a remarkable work in last 2 years. Happy Doctors' Day to all. Rajasthan Cancer Foundation has been in working in tobacco control and NCDs control for over 2 decades. Since you have asked as to how we can collaborate, I think we can perhaps help you with the empowerment and training exercises in tobacco cessation specifically and NCD control. So you'll always be very welcome. Whatever you ask, we should be able to do that.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Rakesh Gupta. Dr. Sibia.
Hello.
Your organization,
I'm Dr. Sibia from Ludhiana, and it's really great to be over here with all of you. It's always nice to be with Dr. Rakesh, and this event has been wonderfully organized. In most of the webinars, the clarity is not as much as in this. All thanks to Dr. Rakesh. And we are really proud to have Dr. Jagatram over here with us. It was great to have him here. And Dr. Astha has also done her job wonderfully. When we are talking about the problem at this time, about Corona, this Institute for Public Health has a great role to play. Because other than the COVID problems, I personally feel the bigger comorbidity in India is due to the lack of education, lack of healthcare, and poverty. I think these three factors should be added to the comorbidity. But if these were taken care of, I think our comorbidity would have been much less. As far as our collaboration is concerned, we are always available. Dr. Rakesh has seen our conference hall. It is always available for any activity of the institute. And this can be an information center for people of Ludhiana and around Ludhiana. We are available for every type of collaboration, every type of help that is possible. In fact, it will be our pleasure to be associated in whatever way we can be. Thank you. And I'm really glad to be here. Thank you very much, Rakesh.
Thank you, Dr. Sibia. Dr. Sanjeev.
Thank you, Dr. Rakesh Gupta. First of all, I compliment Dr. Rakesh Gupta, Dr. Sonu Goyal, and others who conceived this institution. This was the need of the day. In public health, what we lack today is the strategic direction. And this institute, by name, is looking at those areas. In terms of what support I can offer, I'm always available in my personal. And my first love, as some of you know, is building leadership as a field professor. I've been working on this for the last 15 years, and I knew nothing about leadership till I realized, as a digital advisor for 22 countries in Central Eastern Europe, that I was never trained. I only knew the spelling of leadership. Public health expert who has risen to one of the highest positions in a UN organization. I did my MBA, and that opened my eyes, and then I realized I will dedicate rest of my life in building capacity. So that's on personal level. On institutions which I am part of, I am not working full time. I am in honorary capacity chief. Indian Academy of Public Health of Indian Public Health Association. I am also chair of Indian Alliance of Patient Group. This group includes 40 disease condition patient groups who look after and advocate for the interests of the patient group. So I can bring in that perspective. from these organization, and I also continue as honorary professor of leadership and strategic management at International Institute of Global Health of England. So with my 44 years of experience in public health across more than 20 countries and having worked at top positions in policy making in Government of India and also heading academic in India, I will bring in whatever little I have learned and can contribute in an humble manner to the work of CIFAR. And congratulations to the institution. You started very well. And I'm sure you will be setting the direction of public health.
Thank you, Dr. Sanjeev. And thanks for writing forward for the annual report. So I request all dignitaries to please introduce yourself, dwell upon the potential collaborative opportunities with CIFAR, and restrict to 1.5 minutes, right? So Mr. Ajab Singh is with us. He's running a very old NGO from a place near Chandigarh, correct? So Mr. Ajab Singh.
Good morning, all of you, Dr. Sab. Thank you so much for organizing such a beautiful workshop for us. And really, it has been my pleasure for working with you while you are here in Kharad, as well as at the head office. And I have been working on as a district health society, as a member there, a member to the PCP entity advisory, and a member to the drug addiction and rehabilitation society. I'm also working with the district legal service authority, you know, with a vast experience and as well as a tobacco task force. So for the last 6 to 8 years, I have been actively involved in all these type of activities and mother-child care, health services as well. And I have been attending your workshops.
Jayab Singh. Now I'll request Dr. R.P. Gupta, the President, IDA Chandigarh.
Good afternoon to everybody. Firstly, I want to place my gratitude to...
Very nice for me to just augmenting my services in any sphere. Yeah, most welcome, sir. Most welcome, sir.
First, I want to introduce myself. I am Dr. R.P. Gupta, President of Indian Dental Association Chandigarh State Branch and President of International College of Dentists, Section 6, comprising India, Sri Lanka, and Nepal. I am representing these two organizations. And first, my gratitude to Dr. Rakesh Gupta and Professor Sonu Goyal for inviting us from these organizations and registering us. Thank you so much. We are grateful to you. And firstly, that the tremendous work which your organization has done in 2 years is a remarkable one. Sometimes I was feeling guilty to listen all that. I'm a Rotarian in Chandigarh from the last 30 years. Our Rotarian cannot do that much job which you have done in 2 years. Anyway, I will learn so many things with you. I will be with you with every project, wherever you consider me eligible. Now, we are already looking after these as the Indian Dental Association. The No Tobacco Control Program is very dear to the Indian Dental Association. We are regularly conducting the course for the dental surgeons in whole of the India. It is a Central India program. In Chandigarh also, this year we could not conduct it, but from the last so many years, we are regularly conducting program for the dental surgeons, how to help the public, and of course, public rally, etc. We were always, every year we were doing it. I want to request you that even this year, Rotary, I have given two responsibilities myself. First is I'm a chairperson of the primary healthcare and non-communicable disease. I will definitely like to associate with you with these two things. The whole of the Rotary in our district is quite big. Its name is 3080. It goes up to Uttarachal, Missouri, then whole of the Himachal up to Shimla, Haryana up to Panipat, and like this, in Punjab also up to Bangladesh. So I will request you, not taking much time, that anything which as IDA or ICD. ICD, you will be surprised to know, ICD has done a wonderful job in this COVID program. They have interviewed two dental surgeons men representing their association, one in Italy and another in Germany. In Italy, the dental surgeons were having some medical degree because there's medical graduate also joined dentistry later on by doing specialization, maybe condensed course of the graduate dentistry. And they have served the COVID patients, and you'll be surprised to know that 12 dentists lost their life during the serving.
Thank you, Dr. RP. Actually, we are short of time. And you can just tell us all what we can do for you and how we can collaborate with you, right? Thanks a lot. So I'll now request Dr. Nancy. She's from Department of Dietetics in PGI.
A very good morning to all of you. A beautifully organized program, Dr. Rakesh. Many congratulations. And being a nutritionist, I would like to give this message that nutrition is a backbone of all the things. Like it is a backbone of good health. So in time of this crisis like COVID-19, nutrition is actually playing a very important role. In PGI, we strive our level best to give nutritious food to all the patients, which is rich in antioxidants, micro and macronutrients. And even for the preventive measures, one has to be very particular about all the nutrients. There should be no malnutrition that should be checked. Malnutrition means either undernutrition or overnutrition, because people who have obesity, who have the comorbidities like diabetes or some heart issues and all, they are at the receiving end of this virus. Everybody knows that. Why? Because of the faulty lifestyle, faulty nutrition. So this is very important. And if you look at the undernutrition side, there are so many micronutrients like vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, which have to be taken, as well as macronutrients, that is protein. So protein has to be taken care of. So this it actually plays a very, very important role. And I have been fortunate enough to be in PGI, as well as be associated with you in your various programs like anti-hypertension and all these programs. So many, many congratulations, and we hope to make this nation nutritionally strong, because as said, that lack of awareness, lack of knowledge is the culprit. So that has to be taken care of, and the message has to be spread so that we all build a strong immunity against all these diseases and viruses. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Nancy. So I'll now request Dr. Amarjeet Singh, HOD, Department of Community Medicine. Dr. Amarjeet Singh. Sir, please unmute yourself. Sir. Yeah, thank you.
Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you, sir.
So, am I supposed to speak?
Yeah, sure, sir.
Namaste, Shastriya Kal, Adab. मैंने सिर्फ इतना कहना है कि ये बहुत अच्छा सब लोगों ने बोला. मेरा सिर्फ ये मानना है कि साल में 365 दिन है. हर दिन अब तो इतना हो गया, हर दिन कोई दो दिन भी मनाए जा रहे हैं, एक दिन में दो दो दिन. वैलेंटाइन डे 20 साल पहले नहीं होता था, अब होता है. अब चार दिन का वैलेंटाइन डे भी हो रहा है. तो डॉक्टर्स डे हम सिर्फ कस्टमरी तौर पे, रस्मी तौर पे ना मनाएं, यानी कि आज मनाया कल भूल गए. तो ये ज्यादातर हो रहा है. हम डॉक्टर लोग हैं, डॉक्टरी महकमे में हैं, मेडिसिन वाले हैं. हम अगर दिन ये मनाते हैं तो जैसे हम बोलते हैं कि कई बार कि करवा चौथ पे भाई व्रत रख लिया, शाम को पति की शक्ल छलनी में लगा के देख ली, अब बाकी दिन पति कपड़े धो रहा है. तो ये पॉइंट ये है कि हमारे सारे दिन डॉक्टरों के दिन हैं, सारे दिन मरीजों के दिन हैं, सारे दिन पब्लिक के दिन हैं. अगर हम सीरियसली ये करना चाहते हैं तो सिफर एक मीडियम है. अब मुझे ये पक्का पता है कि डॉक्टर सोनू गोयल, डॉक्टर राकेश और उनकी पूरी टीम ये इंश्योर करेगी कि ये एक बिल्कुल एक फॉर्मेलिटी या सिर्फ वो ना रह जाए, एक टेम्परेरी चीज. इसको ऐसा करें कि हम ठान लें कि अगर आज हमने 2020 में 1 जुलाई को डॉक्टर्स डे मनाना है तो सिफर अगले साल इसी दिन के लिए ये कह पाए कि डॉक्टर जो हम लोग हैं या डॉक्टरी महकमा है या डॉक्टर मेडिकल फील्ड है उसके लिए वाकई हमने कुछ किया, टेंजिबल दिखना चाहिए। तो मेरी शुभकामनाएं हैं, बेस्ट विशेस, आई एम ऑल विद यू। मेरे लायक कोई काम है, कुछ भी है तो मैं इसके लिए तैयार हूँ। डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन स्कूल ऑफ पब्लिक हेल्थ पीजीआई चंडीगढ़ के थ्रू, जिसमें कि हमारे पास लीडरशिप डॉक्टर जगतराम की बहुत अच्छी है, सारी टीम, सारे डॉक्टर लोग हम इसमें तत्पर हैं, बिल्कुल तैयार हैं इसके लिए काम करने के लिए। तो हम सब साथ हैं और नेचुरली कोरोना तो छोटी सी चीज़ है, हम मैं कहूँगा छोटी सी चीज़ है, बड़े ही लोग डरे हुए हैं, और भी कई आएंगे। इसमें बहादुरी से हम सब लोगों ने काफ़ी काम किया है और करेंगे। थैंक यू,
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया। और स्कूल ऑफ पब्लिक हेल्थ के बिना तो हम कभी कुछ कर ही नहीं पाएंगे, सो थैंक्स फॉर ऑफरिंग अस ऑल द सर्विसेज, थैंक यू सर। नाउ आई विल रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर ग्रोवर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सेक्रेटरी पीजीआई चंडीगढ़। डॉक्टर ग्रोवर, डॉक्टर ग्रोवर, आर यू विद अस सर?
I think we can take next in the meantime.
Okay. Dr. P.C. Gupta, sir. Director Healy.
Okay, Rakesh.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. First of all, I will endorse everything good that has been said about you, CIFAR, this function, and all the activities of CIFAR. I endorse all that, and your team that you have built up along with Dr. Sonu Goyal and PGI Chandigarh. I can see as that we have lots of shared common interest. Yeah. In terms of research, in terms of dissemination, in terms of the subject matter. We are all very much interested in tobacco control. We are very much interested in NCD control. And that is the strength of my institute also. I direct Healy Seksaria Institute for Public Health. Just to introduce myself, and I have been in the area of epidemiological research for a long time, over half a century. And the strength areas are tobacco control and NCD control, cancer control. So we can collaborate. We can start our collaboration very fast by working on research papers, thinking about dissemination. So there is a lot of scope for collaboration.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the support. And Dr. Meera Agi. Dr. Meera Agi ji.
Thank you, Rakesh. Sorry. Can you see me?
Yeah.
Thank you, Rakesh. I'm really overwhelmed with what I have heard today. My God, everyone is ready to help you. So I am just a petty behavioral scientist, and all that I can say is that I stand ready to assist in whatever I can and whatever you think I can do for you. Thank you very much, and the best of wishes to CIFAR. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Dr. Rana J. Singh from the Union.
Yes. Yes. Can you hear me, Dr. Gupta?
Yes.
So, first of all, good afternoon to all of you. I am again introducing myself, Dr. Rana J. Singh. I am working with the International Union Against Tuberculosis and Lung Disease for tobacco and non-communicable diseases in the region. First of all, I would like to congratulate Dr. Rakesh Gupta, President and Director of Public Health, Mr. Arun Verma and their team at Strategic Institute for Public Health and Education on the release of its annual report on this very, very special occasion of Doctors' Day. Congratulations to Dr. Professor Jagatram also on receiving this honor on this day. What I have seen, so in last almost maybe in a very short span of less than 2 years of its existence, it has made an excellent progress in reaching out to communities through evidence-based public health approaches. And it is heartening to know, as we heard in their presentation, that Cypher is gearing up to educate the practitioners and researchers, as well as to prepare public health leaders and managers to serve as focal point for multidisciplinary research and traditional public health. You see, it is evolving every day. But the traditional public health research was also very important. So I convey my best wishes and support to Cypher so that it can play the most distinctive role for which it was developed. And that role is to develop public health education and preparation of public health professionals. Union had already been conducting many activities in collaboration with Cypher. And we will be very happy to work with you, sir, and your team to collaborate on tobacco control, non-communicable control, tuberculosis, and any other communicable disease, and various lung health challenges which are facing our country. So once again, I congratulate you and hope to work and collaborate with you for overall good of the health of the country. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Rana. So, Dr. Swasti Charan, are you with us, sir? Dr. Swasti Charan?
Yes, yes, I'm with you. Thank you, Dr. Rakesh. Thank you for inviting me in this event which you are hosting on Doctors' Day. I was listening to many of the speakers there. We are happy to know that, you know, Doctors' Day needs to be celebrated every day, not just day. We are doing that, but nominally we have identified one day to celebrate the Doctor's Day to reassure ourselves for the commitments that we have for the society. I look after National Tobacco Control Program, National Oral Health Program, and the National Program for the NCDs in India. And I am interested in integrating all the national related national health program, particularly these three, the National Oral Health Program, Tobacco Control Program, and the NCD program. And we are also moving beyond health, and we collaborate very actively with the Feed India movement now, the Feed India mission, and Eating Right in our tries to fight the NCDs. So there will be many areas of collaboration. I have already collaborated with you on many fronts. We would be happy to work with you on many areas, because the more the merrier. The disease burden is huge in the country. The risk factors are huge in the country. We have done something for tobacco, but we have done nothing much for alcohol and physical activity. We have picked up, but for alcohol and other drug abuses, we haven't done much. So these are some of the new areas which I think Cypher should be looking at in the future, given the fact that tobacco is capable for many of these substances of abuse. So over to you, Dr. Rakesh. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Swasti. Dr. Hitanshu Kaur.
Good afternoon, everyone. Can you hear me, Dr. Gupta?
Yeah, we can hear.
Thank you so much for inviting me to be a part of this event. And probably I am the only person from the southern part of India, and I'm in Pondicherry. I am Dr. Hitanshu, and I work in the Department of Preventive and Social Medicine as additional professor. We run an MPH program, and we have a very structured tobacco control module for our MPH students, where we collaborate with PGA, Union, Ministry, Dr. Swasti. Everyone, they have been visited to our place. So I'm very fortunate to be a part of this event, and I think we can collaborate on many fronts. Our strengths are capacity building and research activities. So we'll be happy to help in those activities. I see I'm an alumnus of PGI. So I see Dr. Singh there, my teacher, Dr. Sonu, my other senior resident when I joined there. So it was lovely to be connected again, and it feels like homecoming. So thank you so much for this opportunity.
Thank you. Dr. Monica Roda from HIDE and PHFI.
Good afternoon, everyone, and happy Doctors' Day to all the doctors in the group. I am a professor director of and a health practice area of adolescent health. My huge congratulations to Dr. Rakesh Gupta and colleagues for excellent achievements of CIFR. Our areas of work very closely align with CIFR's activities, and both the institutes can benefit greatly through collaborative working, both the area of research as well as capacity building. We offer many online training courses in tobacco control, health promotion, NCP prevention and control, and we'll be very happy. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Monica. Dr. Surila, SP Surila.
Dr. Rakesh, you are hearing?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Good afternoon, Dr. Rakesh, and all the dignitaries. I am Dr. S.P. Surila, and I am president of the Sneha, a social network for education and health awareness. So we are connected with anti-tobacco activities for the last 17 years. And we contributed especially in Mohali and Punjab, making these areas tobacco smoke free. So appreciating the doctors and the frontline warriors at the National Doctors Day 22 is really a great tribute and a great achievement for this CIFR. And I thank you, Dr. Gupta, for your team. And a few points are there that I have learned a lot from this seminar, which was a great occasion. We should know that our emphasis should be towards this raising the tobacco users' age, that is 21 to 25 years. This is one point. Another, of course, banning the e-cigarettes. And then this hookah culture is, of course, now has again, we have seen in Chandigarh a few days back, there were many youngsters using this hookah. Then we know this, the tobacco is causing the additional comorbidity, which we already having other diseases, especially in the corona period. So we should be now having this special campaign to make the public aware of this point, which makes the our population more vulnerable to the disease. So I congratulate CIFR. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Surila. Dr. Pratima Murthy from NIMHANS. She's with us.
Hi, good afternoon. Just to echo everybody else's congratulations so that, you know, on this wonderful occasion, and particularly congratulations to Rakesh, Dr. Sonu and the others. I'm professor and head of the Department of Psychiatry at the National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences. And it's very nice to meet a whole lot of friends who are working in the same area of tobacco control, particularly tobacco cessation, other drugs of abuse. We have a very large center for addiction medicine at our institute. And of course, we're one of the most premier institutes in mental health in the country. So these are all areas with which, you know, we could collaborate with you, and all the very best to all of you. And particularly in the times of COVID, I think celebrating Doctors Day is very, very important. So happy Doctors Day to everybody. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Dr. Ravi Mehrotra. Dr. Ravi Mehrotra, are you with us, sir? Dr. Ravi Mehrotra?
I think he's not here.
Okay. Dr. Arpit Gupta.
Well, hello everyone, and many thanks to Dr. Rakesh and Dr. Sonu for this opportunity. I am an assistant professor at the Oral Health Sciences Center of PGI and working under the dynamic leadership of Dr. Jagat Ram. I do consider myself as a part of your team, sir, and as you are aware, I have been in some way or the other involved in many of the activities of CIFR. And as a general secretary of Indian Dental Association, Chandigarh State Branch, I can say that we stand by CIFR in all of its endeavors, and we have a lot of common interests as far as tobacco control is concerned, oral health and NCDs are concerned. And we look forward to various activities, maybe in terms of capacity building, research, and public awareness. So do take us as part of your team. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Apit. Dr. Sandeep. Dr. Sandeep, SPO, NPCDCS.
Yeah, I'm Dr. Sandeep Singh. I'm State Program Officer for NPCDCS. And first of all, congratulations, Dr. Rakesh, and all the team at Cypher, you know, for celebrating Doctors' Day in this fashion, which is very, you know, I feel very privileged, you know, that we are doing it in the Corona times. We are celebrating our personalities and the people who have worked, you know, so hard, Professor Jagatram and Professor Reddy and all the other dignitaries who have been contributing, all the doctors who have been contributing to the society. Here in DHS, you know, we are already working on NCDs, you know, for Baku is also, of course, one of the main community, you know, which is affecting health and outcomes. And our special connect is Rakesh, because he's from directorate itself. Yes, sir has worked on tobacco cessation a lot, and so Cypher has a direct liaison with us, you know, through Dr. Rakesh. And thank you everyone for giving this opportunity to be with them. Thank you, Dr. Rakesh.
Thanks a lot, sir. Dr. Sandeep Grover, are you with us, sir? Dr. Sandeep Grover. Dr. T.P. Singh from Max Hospital. Dr. T.P. Singh. Dr. Nitin Mathur, General Secretary, IMA. Dr. Nitin Mathur. So Dr. Rita Bhardwaj, she is the former Director of Family Welfare. Dr. Rita, are you with us? Dr. Rita, you can unmute yourself. Dr. Preeti from Chitkara. Dr. Preeti.
Good afternoon. I also take this opportunity to congratulate everyone, particularly the Cypher team, for your very proactive approach. And as I also join the others in wishing Happy Doctors' Day to all, and wishing everybody stays healthy, stays safe, and continue with Saving Lives initiative. I really feel that you know, you have provided a platform where different groups can work synergistically and recommit to improving healthcare. So in terms of collaborations, we are offering through the Chitpara School of Health Sciences, we are teaching basically allied health sciences students, optometry students, physiotherapy, occupational therapy, as well as students in healthcare management and hospital management. So what I feel is we have expertise which is complementary to your expertise. So if there is any way we can partner, whether it is for webinars, projects, research, that is easily possible besides training. Particular strengths that we would be able to offer would be we have a large youth population. And at this point, we are working with the youth in looking at how can we build their resilience. So that's a project that we are working with the students. And I think if the resilience is good, then they will not get into probably addictive behaviors. Another area of interest has been artificial intelligence, whether we could work in the area of anything that is required in the area of artificial intelligence. So if there is anything specific, we would be glad to partner. At this point, I would just like to say we are highly interested and thank you for this opportunity.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Preeti. Dr. Amit Yadav. Dr. Amit, are you with us? Dr. Amit? Dr. Ravi Mehrotra, he has joined us now. Dr. Ravi Mehrotra. Dr. Ravi, are you with us?
Good afternoon, all of you. It's a pleasure to interact with you, such a good group. And I put the video off, but my audio was on as to hear what is happening. So my congratulations to not only Dr. Rakesh and Dr. Goyal and all his group, but the entire CIFR team. What I've just been through your, what you've been doing in the last couple of years, and I must say remarkable progress in this very important area. As you know, I look after the Cancer Consortium from the Indian Council of Medical Research. And earlier I was heading the Tobacco FCTC Global Hub at National Institute of Cancer Prevention. So what you are saying is very close to my heart. And whatever I can possibly help you and interact with you in any which way, please do feel absolutely free to ask me. And in case from the Indian Council of Medical Research and on my personal behalf, I can be of help, I'll be the happiest person. Thank you so much, and I wish you all the best.
Thanks a lot, sir, for joining us. Is Dr. Nitin back? Nitin Mathur, General Secretary IMA, is he back? Dr. Rita Bhardwaj? Dr. Amit Yadav?
Hello.
Yeah.
Anji, yes. Dr. Rakesh, I'm there.
Yeah, thank you.
So happy Doctor's Day to everybody. So you
introduce yourself.
Yeah, please. I'm Dr. Rita Bhardwaj. I have worked as Director of Health Services, Punjab Family Welfare. So Dr. Rakesh has been doing a tremendous job for Kotapa. He has always been there in all the districts. He has been a great help. And now he's running this cipher, which is a very good step. And I hope I give all my good wishes to him so that he can continue the good work. And my contribution in whichever form you desire would always be there. And my best wishes to this institute and to congratulations to you, to Dr. Sonu, Dr. Astha, for holding this wonderful interaction. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rita. Is Dr. Sharing Bhutia with us? She's from Salaam, Bombay. Dr. Sharing, are you with us? So I may just tell that Dr. Sharing Bhutia, she's Vice President, Tobacco Control and Advocacy, Salaam, Bombay. She was with us for some time. I think she may be having another meeting. Ishita Mathur, is she with us? Dr. Amit Yadav, are you back?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Okay. Right. But please introduce yourself, sir.
Hello, I'm audible, right?
Yeah, you're audible.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, sir, for giving this opportunity to just talk here, and I think I'll wish everyone a very happy Doctor's Day, and it's a day for the lifesavers for us, and especially in this COVID time, I think there's no one more in terms of engaged and at the front than the doctors of our country, and we are very grateful to each and every one of them, and it's so wonderful that you have organized this like in terms of platform where we could express our views and listen to so many experts on Doctor's Day. And I've just completed my postdoc at the University of California Center for Tobacco Research and Education, and I've come back to India, and I hope I would be able to contribute to much more tobacco control discussion and work in the country in times to come. And I look forward to support and be of any assistance to people working in India. Once again, a very happy Doctor's Day to everyone, and look forward to collaborate and work with you all.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Amit. Is Dr. Ravindra Khaiwal with us? Dr. Ravindra? So Dr. Ravindra is Associate Professor, in Department of Community Medicine. So he was with us for some time. Priyanka Dhawan, are you with us? So Gurleen, please introduce yourself. She's our team member. Gurleen.
Hello. Good afternoon, everyone, and happy Doctors' Day to all. It is a very prestigious day for doctors and for medical field especially. I am working as finance commandment officer in a School of Public Health and in collaboration with Cypher, and looking forward to many more opportunities for this. Thank you.
Surbhi Sharma. Surbhi, are you listening? Dr. Nidhi, are you with us? Saurabh Sharma, he's also our team member.
Hello.
Yeah, Saurabh.
Good afternoon, everyone. Happy Doctor Days to everyone. I am Saurabh Sharma. I am working as a RCCM consultant in working in Cypher. Thank you.
And Arshdeep.
Good afternoon, everyone. Yeah. Happy Doctor Day. I'm Arshdeep Singh, Project Officer, Transfer. Thank you.
And Dr. Nidhi. Okay, Dr. Asta.
Yeah.
Dr. Asta, you can just ask Mr. Arun Verma to propose a vote of thanks.
Yes. Thank you, Dr. Rakesh. Thank you all. And now I'd like Mr. Arun Verma to give a vote of thanks.
Thank you, Dr. Asta, and a very good afternoon to everyone. On behalf of Cypher, it's my profound privilege to propose a vote of thanks to our chief guest, Padma Shri Dr. Jagat Ram, Professor and Head Department of Thermology and Director of Postgraduate Institute for Medical Education and Research, Chandigarh, all our guests of honor, eminent experts, and board of directors, and our efficient and very hardworking team. Today's being Doctors' Day, I would take this opportunity on behalf of Cypher to thank the entire medical fraternity and the paramedic staff of our country who have been working and are working 24/7 to provide the medical support and services in treatment of corona infected patients by risking their own as well as their family members' lives. In this process, a large number of doctors and paramedic staff have acquired infection and lost their lives. As Dr. Asta told us, that more than 300 doctors have sacrificed during this period, and their family members are also suffering on that account. So we salute them and their families for the sacrifice for this country they have given. Happy Doctors' Day to all of you, and thank you, and one for all. Thank you, one and all, for joining with us today. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you all who have joined us.